So we had discussed the van der Waal equation, and van der Waal equation is P plus A n square by V square. Into V minus NB is equals to NRT. N is the number of moles, A is the pressure correction factor, stands for intermolecular interaction, B is the volume correction factor, stands for the size of the gaseous molecule, more size, more will be the value of B. Okay? Now, we'll see next the calculation of compressibility factor in different condition. In different condition. So for all these things, we are assuming one mole. So N value is one here. Okay, so first condition is at low pressure and moderate temperature. And moderate temperature. So we have this van der Waal equation, that is P plus A by V square, because N value is 1, into V minus B is equals to RT. Okay. Now we have low pressure. It means the volume is high because volume and number of moles, sorry, volume and pressure is inversely proportional. So at low pressure, what condition we can apply? Vm is high. And when the Vm is high, then we can take the approximation, that is Vm minus B is almost equals to Vm, where we are assuming. B is negligible in comparison to Vm, and we can take this approximation. Now we substitute this here and we get P plus A by Vm square into Vm is equals to RT. We need to find out Z, okay? So we'll multiply Vm here. So it is PVm plus A by Vm is equal to RT. We'll divide RT both sides. So it becomes PVm by RT is equals to 1 minus A by Vm RT. This is nothing but the compressibility factor. So Z is equals to 1 minus A by Vm RT. So under this condition, low pressure and moderate temperature, okay, the value of Z we are getting, it is less than 1. And we have seen this condition, when Z is less than 1, it is easier to compress. Once again, or it should be Vm better. Done. This one. Wait, let me see. What exactly qualifies as moderate temperature, low pressure? No, actually it is not actually defined, moderate temperature and all. When you get the questions, they'll mention the same term, that moderate temperature, low temperature or high temperature, because for different gases, we have different value. Okay, so we cannot define this. It's not a general term. Okay, so yes. Yeah, so this is the first condition we have, okay. Now, the second condition you see, at high pressure and moderate temperature. At high pressure and moderate temperature. Okay. So when the pressure is high, we can take the assumption here, A plus P plus A by Vm B square is almost equals to P. We can neglect this term here because the pressure is high here, right? And then we substitute this in van der Waal equation. So P into Vm minus B is equals to RT. So PVm minus PB is equals to RT. Divide RT this side, so it is PVm by RT is equals to 1 plus PB by RT. Okay, so the value of Z here, 1 plus PB by RT. And that is what the value of Z we require. So under this condition, the value of Z is greater than 1. And when it is greater than 1, it is difficult to compress, but easier to expand. Repulsive force dominates the attractive force here. That also we can write. Easier to expand. Done. Okay. The last condition you see for the calculation of this, the value of Z compressibility factor, that is C, at low pressure and high temperature. At low, here we are taking very low pressure actually. At very low pressure, and high temperature. So for the low pressure, we have the same condition. So because of this, we have Vm is high. And hence we can write Vm minus B is almost equals to Vm. Okay. And because of high temperature, when temperature is high, then we can write Ke is high, kinetic energy is high. With high kinetic energy, the velocity of the gaseous particle is high. And what we can write then? Interaction is less. Interaction is less, or we can say negligible. And hence we can equate A to this zero. Almost equals to zero because of less interaction or no interaction. So because of this, all these things, what we can write, P plus A by Vm square is almost equals to P. This two condition, if you apply into Van der Waal equation, you'll get P into Vm is equals to RT, and hence PVm by RT, which is nothing but Z here, is equals to the Van der Waal compressibility factor is equals to 1. And this is the condition of ideal gas behavior you have. Remember in the beginning I said that any gas at low pressure and high temperature behaves as ideal gas, and this is because the value of compressibility factor here, it is coming out to be as 1, and hence the no doubt. Done, guys. No, we don't consider all those inaccuracy because the exact thing we won't calculate. Okay. Those inaccuracy also we are, it's not that great. So we are neglecting that. Okay, you won't get any question where you have to take the actual value, exact value of Z. So that is not required at all. Without approximation, you won't be able to calculate it. Otherwise, the calculation will be a bit tough, very tough in fact. Okay, you required all the value of A, B and everything. So that calculation will be very tough. That's why we don't do that. Okay, look at this question here. Try these questions, all 4. Done. Okay, you see, the first question is the internal pressure loss of one mole of van der Waals gas, that is real gas, over an ideal gas. So we know that this P ideal we had discussed is equals to P plus A n square by V square. This is the pressure of the real gas we have here. And this is the pressure of the ideal gas, right? So difference is what? Internal pressure loss of one mole of van der Waals gas and real and this. So we need to have the difference here is P ideal minus P, that is P real, is equals to A times N square by V square. N value is given one mole. So A by V square. Hence option C is the correct answer we have here. Okay. The van der Waals equations for CH4 at low pressure. At low pressure means what? Just now we did. Low pressure means volume is high, Vm, right? So Vm minus V, we can equate to V. So what we can write, nothing you have to memorize, just P plus A by V square into V is equals to RT. So now from this, if you solve PV by RT is Z is equals to this. So Z is equals to 1 minus A by VRT. This is the expression we have just now we did. So PV plus PV plus A by V is equals to RT. Option B is correct. Which of the following can be most readily liquefied? We haven't done this yet. Okay, it comes under the liquefaction of gas. Liquefaction of gas will be easier when the interaction will be more, right? When A value will be more. So more value of A, easier will be the liquefaction. We'll discuss this later. Okay. So which one has the maximum A value? That is for SO2, I guess. Yeah, SO2. So SO2 can be liquefied easily. Okay. Out of NH3 and N2, which will have larger value of A? NH3 has hydrogen bonding, larger value of A. So for this, we have NH3, larger value of B. What we can say? N2 has large molecular size. So for this one, it will be N2. Size of N2 is more. This kind of question is, you know, a bit difficult to understand, like which one has more size or less. But usually you see nitrogen and hydrogen. We have here the other atom. Here we have nitrogen, nitrogen. Okay. But when you solve some questions, you should have the understanding of it. Means a bit of memory, you have to memorize this kind of thing, that N2 and other gas. All these things you will understand once you solve some questions. Okay, whenever you get this question, take a note of it and revise before the test. That's what you can do in this type of question. Okay. Understood? Right? One more question you see. I'll share this now. This one you try. You need to find out the pressure. 5P divided by 5.277, this value you need to find out. It's a numerical type question. Yes, obviously, A value is given, no? So you have to use van der Waal. See, volume occupied by CO2 molecules is negligible, right? It means what we can say, B is negligible here. So you can remove B in B minus B term. And then you can multiply this and find out pressure from there. You will get a quadratic in V, and that quadratic you need to solve to get P. One condition you need to apply over there. You're getting 8 to 8.5. Okay, but the question is something else, Ashwath. I think you are close. Question is P divided by 5.277. Isn't it? See, what we'll do here, we have the equation, Van der Waal equation, that is P plus A n square by V square into V minus NB is equals to NRT. Okay, one mole is given, so N is equals to one, we have to substitute, and volume is negligible, right? Volume occupied by CO2 is negligible. It means B is equals to zero, it is given in the question. So we can write V minus NB is almost equals to V, right? And we substitute it here. So we'll get P plus A by V square into V is equals to RT. Okay. Now, P is equals to what we have? P is equals to, we have RT by V minus A by V square. Okay, you will get a quadratic in V, multiply both sides by V square, so you'll get V square into P minus R into T into V plus A is equals to zero. So V is equals to minus B, that is RT, plus minus B square, R square, T square, minus 4AC. So 4A into P, root over of it, divided by 2A, right? 2 times P. This is the quadratic equation we'll get. Since for a pressure, we have one value of V, two value of V for one single pressure is not possible. And that is the condition satisfies when this term equals to zero, right? When discriminant is equals to zero. So for the single value of P, what we can write R square T square minus 4AP should be equals to zero. So P is equals to R square T square divided by 4a. All value you need to substitute here. Value of p is 0.0821. Square into t is given 300 square divided by 4a value is given 3.59. You can assume this as 3.6. Question is 3 divided by 5.277. So this into 5.277. What is this value you are getting? You can use calculator if you want. Because you see, for a single pressure, we cannot have two different volumes. No? P and V, for a given value of pressure, V should be unique. So that plus minus term should be zero. So what is this value you are getting? Acha, you are getting it as 8. I think 8 is the answer. That's what someone got, no? Shashwat, you got 8 only, right? Because the question is this only. P divided by 5.277. That's the value you need to find out. That's why I divided. Yeah, approximately the answer would be 8 you will get. Is it? Are you getting it as 8? Yeah, roughly so it is 8 we'll get, right? Adija, I didn't get you. Come again. Yeah. Right, the question is P divided by 5.277. Understood, right? Yeah. Okay, one last question you see. The question is calculate the diameter of helium from its van der Waal constant B, the value of B is given. It is 24 centimeter cube mole inverse. Try this. Okay, so you see here, B value is given, and formula of B is what? B is equals to 4 into Na into V, right? V is the volume of the one molecule. So 4 times Na, Na you can take 6 into 10 to the power 23, approximate, into 4 by 3 pi R cube. Okay, so this would be 4 into 4, 16, 16 into 6 is 96. So 96 into 10 to the power 23 into R cube, pi is 3.14 divided by 3. So for approximation, like this two you can cancel out. I'm not doing it here, but you can cancel out this two. And we can say the formula of B in terms of radius directly you can use approximately is 10 to the power 23 into R cube. This also you can use directly sometimes. Okay, even in some books, they give this formula like this one. Right, then you substitute the value of B here and you will get R cube as B divided by 24 into 96 into 10 to the power 23 24 divided by 96 into 23, 96, what I write? 96 into 10 to the power 23. And then you can find out R from this. Diameter is 2 into R. So we can find out that also. Okay. We can do one more thing just to solve this. We can multiply here by 8. And this side also will multiply by 8. And this becomes, from here we can write 2R to the power cube is equals to 24 into 8 divided by 96, 10 to the power 23. So this is 4 times, this is 2 times. So 2 into 20 into 10 to the power minus 24. This approximately you can solve 2R to the power cube is equals to this, which you can solve. So 20 cube root is 2.5 to 2.6. Okay, and then you can get the answer. Understood, guys? Yes, exact answer is 267 picometer is given. Okay, so like this, there's some basic formula we have that we'll use and we'll find out the answer in all these kind of questions. Okay, so next class we'll finish this chapter. There are a few things left. Okay, we'll finish this in the next class and then we'll start a new chapter. Yeah, I'll share the DBP. Meanwhile, you can solve the center module. Okay. Pranav, you cross-check this. Just let me know. Okay. Method is this only. By solving this, you'll get the answer. Fine, guys. Anything else, tell me. Okay, different values you are getting. Anyways, you understood the method how to do this. Okay, you try this once, you'll get the answer. Fine, guys, thank you so much. See you in the next class. Okay, and submit your assignment on time. Okay, whatever you have done, submit it on time. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, bye.